gracious hosts, unique lodging, and tasty cuisine. New Mexico bed and breakfasts are New Mexico true. Our innkeepers are as special as New Mexico, and we're sharing their stories. Read about them and plan your trip at nmbba.org. Hey, everybody. Welcome to Big Blend Radio with Nancy and Lisa. Every second Thursday, we get to talk about New Mexico, where to stay, where to play, where to eat, where to be merry, what to do. And today we're going to talk about summer travel and summer bed and breakfast destinations. But we're actually going to go to Abiquiu in New Mexico. And this is our show that we do every second Thursday with the New Mexico Bed and Breakfast Association. So I encourage you to go to their website, because if you want a real New Mexico true adventure, go to nmbba.org, standing for New Mexico Bed and Breakfast Association. So nmbba.org. And we've got Carolyn and Tom Calfee. They own and run the Grand Hacienda in Abiquiu Lake. Their website is thegrandhacienda.com. So welcome back to the show, Carolyn and Tom. How are you?
We're great. Thanks for having us.
Hey, it's good to have you.
We're excited to be back.
Yeah. So you guys are open year round. I thought it looked like you guys took a little vacation for a bit.
You know, we are now closed in the off season. So in the off season, you know, we get snow and it's kind of cold and George O'Keefe closes and, you know, life slows down. So we made a decision last year to close from November through mid-April. And we are open full starting mid-April through the end of October.
Awesome. Awesome. So when you talk about Georgia O'Keeffe, so do you want to just touch on that for everybody, where Abiquiu Lake is, Lake Abiquiu, and where you are in regards to Santa Fe? Because I know, I think, aren't they getting a new gallery or museum for her?
They are. It's going to be a whole city block, large new museum. So they apparently have a lot of her items that are stored away, never seen by the public. So they're going to be able to bring a lot of that out. So the George O'Keefe Museum in Santa Fe is going to be incredible. But out here in Abiquiu is where Georgia lived, and she had two homes here, one at Ghost Ranch, and then one in the Village. And the one in the Village, you can still tour her home, studio, and gardens. And they also have a wonderful welcome center, which right now has an exhibition going on of a lot of her personal effects in that welcome center. So even if you don't take the tour, you should definitely stop by the welcome center.
Very cool. Very cool. So how far is Georgia O'Keeffe's, you know, her museum and her summer home that's near you, basically, right?
Well, actually, she called her winter and her summer home. So she called Ghost Ranch, which is directly across the lake from the picture behind you. She had a home there, which she lived in the summer. It didn't have heating and wasn't really weatherproofed. And then in the winter, she would move into her home in the Village, of Abiquiu, which, you know, is a very small, it used to be a pueblo, and now it's just a very small village, and her home is still there. And that's the one that you can tour. You cannot do it at Ghost Ranch.
Oh, you can't. I thought people could go there.
You can't tour her house at Ghost Ranch, but you can take tours that bring you to all the places where she painted, and you can
see that's cool.
Where she did her, you know, did her paintings. And it's kind of cool because you can look and see what she saw in reality, and then you can look at a copy of her painting and see how she interpreted that. So it's a pretty cool tour to take.
Wow. That's nice. I like that.
Tom, do you want to refresh us about the two of you deciding to go to Lake Abiquiu and open up the Grand Hacienda? I mean, what led you there, and just kind of refresh people's memory on that for those, and those who are new listening, your journey?
Yeah, it started out in 2005 when we first came out here, and I saw a lot for sale and brought the family out the very next day, and we bought it the third day that we saw it. So our attraction was just immediate. And like Georgia will often say, or did often say, that that she's not sure that Abiquiu probably found her. And kind of same with us. It just felt like we needed to be here. And so we built a little house. Our job kept us from
grand house.
Well, our first one was a little house, though, but that we built in 2010. And their VRBOs and Airbnbs didn't really exist so much. It was early on in that genre. And so we thought we'd put it up for rent for a weekly basis, and maybe we'd get a few rentals out of it. And what happened was is it rented so much that we couldn't even stay there. And so we just progressed on with another rental. Same thing happened. And then when Carolyn left the financial industry about 8 years ago now, we decided, why don't we just come out here full time and try a B&B, because we've never done that before. So let's give it a shot.
Very cool. So where did you move from?
It was, we've spent most of our life in Chicago, but prior to here, we spent 8 years in Dallas, and now we've been out here for 5 years.
Oh, wow. So Chicago, yeah, financial world, Chicago, ding, 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 yep. But Dallas, yeah, so you got a little bit of a groove into the Southwest terrain and, you know, understanding, you know, the weather. But New Mexico is different than the Dallas region in regards to, it's still Southwest, obviously, but it's, it can still get chilly at night in your area, right, in the summer.
Yeah, well, in the summer, it stays pretty good. In fact, in the summer, we almost welcome some of the cooler nights because it's nice sleeping with the windows open, and you don't get a chance to do that in Dallas too often in the summer months. So we enjoy that aspect of it. But it's just such, you know, the air is clean, the water's clean, just everything around us is, the pollution just pretty much doesn't exist in this part of the world. And that part,
that's nice.
We were just really, really attracted to that kind of living and thought it was important at this stage in our life to be out here and get more of that.
And so you've got a tiny little village, really, that Abiquiu is like a little village. So let's kind of give people the idea of what they can experience. Obviously, they can go tour the Georgia O'Keeffe sites, but Carolyn, is there hiking, that kind of thing during the summer months that people can experience? And how far are you from Santa Fe again?
We're about an hour and 15 minutes from Santa Fe and an hour and 15 minutes from Taos. So certainly when people stay here, we always suggest they do a day trip into Santa Fe to see it, but then come back home because it's so beautiful here. But in the summer is absolutely the best time to be in Abiquiu, and there's so much going on. So you mentioned hiking. This is like a hiker's paradise. There are incredible hiking trails everywhere. You know, Ghost Ranch has a lot of them. You can hike up to kind of Puebloan ruins. You can hike around the lake. So, you know, guests who stay with us, we will give them all a list of our 50 favorite hikes. I mean, there really are so many hikes here that you could stay here for months and hit different trails every single day. And the cool thing is sometimes you go out on these trails, you won't even see anybody else. It'll just be like you in your own private little world. So it's an incredible place to hike. But it's not just hiking. There's biking trails. And then of course we have the lake that viewers can see behind you too. And this lake offers all kinds of wonderful things to do in the summer. So if you can go kayaking, you can go river rafting. We actually have a river wave where when they let water out of the dam, if they let enough water out, they've built kind of a natural river wave. So you can bring surfboards, or boogie boards and do some river waving. There's fly fishing and regular fishing. So the lake offers just an abundant amount of activities. But some of the other things I wanted to mention that go on in Abiquiu in the summer is art, because we have an artist studio tour, which happens in October in Abiquiu, where all the artists in the area open up their studios. And there's, I think, 150 to 200 different artists that you can visit on this weekend and go into their studios and see how they create their art and talk to them and meet them. And in nearby El Rito, there's also a studio tour. So those two studio tours. But the most exciting thing that's happening this year for the first time is on August 25th and 6th. It's called Blossoms and Bones, and it's going to be a huge music festival out at Ghost Ranch. And a two-day festival. You just hang out on the lawn underneath the moon. And this year, some of the featured groups are Rising Appalachia, Spoon.
Oh, they're awesome.
Well,
I love Rising Appalachia. I love them. They're awesome.
You need to come. And
I've only seen them on YouTube, but they keep, because we keep doing Appalachian stuff on our trips, and they keep coming up. They're awesome. No, they're amazing. Well, that's cool. Great.
Yeah. So there's a whole lineup, two days and nights of just incredible music, and you do it at Ghost Ranch under the red cliffs, under the moon, and it's just beautiful.
Nice.
It's going on this summer too.
I love that.
Oh, but I love that they call it Blossoms and Bones, because that's really, Georgia O'Keeffe did a lot of bone collecting and painting of bones. And, you know, everyone always thinks about her just flowers, but it does, it goes hand in hand to me, you know, with her art, that she would do both, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. And if you tour her house, you'll see she has collections of bones. Like on her windowsills and throughout her house. So you definitely get a sense of that when you tour her house, for sure.
That's cool. That's cool. We saw that in the gallery in Santa Fe. I think it was back in 2019 when we were there, and went on a nice docent trip. Our friend Debbie Stone was a docent there at that time. It was right before COVID. And she's a travel writer, but she would docent there. And she's like, everybody says about the flowers, you know what they say about Georgia O'Keeffe and what she was painting. She said, but it's not true. She painted bones too. No, it's fun. But you know, it's really neat. I mean, New Mexico has like a spiritual quality. Do you find a lot of guests come in just for that rejuvenation, kind of connecting back with earth and just being outdoors and not kind of, you understand Chicago and Dallas. You want to get away from that. You want to get into the peace and solitude.
Yeah, absolutely. In fact, we really have focused this year on what we call our wellness approach, for exactly that reason. People come here and they just want to connect with the land. They want to see the night skies, the dark skies. They want to hike and come back, you know, filled with red clay. And it is a very spiritual land. You know, the Tewa and the Navajo both lived right here where we are. And really nobody has lived here since they were here until those of us who built out here have moved in. So you still find remnants of them when you hike around the land and the country. And you definitely feel that energy. So we've always said that we built this hacienda. It's very, very green. You know, we tried to build it with the land rather than on the land. And we're really grateful for this piece of property and what the land gives back to us and all of our guests.
That's awesome. That's it's a B&B, but it is like someone can come in and book the whole house, right?
We have three suites on the bed and breakfast, and somebody can book the three suites. So there's three guest suites. There's a large, great room where we have a fireplace and a library and a Mercado store and places to eat. We have a guest kitchen, and then we have outdoor terraces. And so someone can rent the whole B&B side if they'd like, or they can just rent one suite. You know, and one other.
I'd like the whole house. Thank you very much. I mean, sure. I'm just saying, I want the hacienda. I want the whole thing.
Come and,
and a bottle of champagne.
There you go. And do that during Blossoms and Bones so you can go to the concert too. But another feature on this, on the Grand Hacienda, is we have this greenhouse. And I want, because we're talking about summer, and one of the great things of summer here is all the fresh fruits and vegetables and herbs that we grow in the farmer's market in town.
Right. See, so people are not going to think that when they're looking at the background, you know, this really rugged, dramatic, gorgeous, complex, you know, terrain. It's gorgeous. That growing is going on, but there is,
And that's why my greenhouse manager is here to talk to you about that.
We do. We start a lot of our plants inside of our greenhouse. And then as it warms up, such as right now, then we're in the process of moving those plants into our plaza area. And we copied what the Native Americans did, what the Navajo did when they were here a couple hundred years ago. Is, in fact, you can see evidence of their farming beds, is they would bring small stones up from the riverbed, from the Shama River, and then they would cover their gardens in those small stones. And they would use those then as where they would, that would be their planting bed. And so by doing that, they could increase their growing season by a month on in the beginning and a month on the end, because those small stones hold heat. And so in our plaza, oh, wow, area, we did that same thing. And so our whole plaza is filled with small stones. And then within those stones, that's where we do our planting and we have our gardens. And then it's also done inside our plaza, because if we didn't enclose it, all the animals here would be very grateful that we were planting food for them. And in fact, we're trying to plant it for our guests. And so we close it off. So keep the animals out.
Yeah.
Except mm-hmm. for the lizards to get through. And for some reason, I give lizards a pass. They're allowed to come through the garden and eat what they eat what they can.
Well, they eat a whole lot of insects. So it's a good
they
deal.
Do. They do. Yeah.
It's a good deal.
Yeah. And so we grow a lot of our herbs. We grow a lot of our vegetables. Every meal that you have here at the Grand Hacienda, we'll have several of whether they be herbs or thyme or chives or tomatoes, or just a whole abundance of
jalapenos.
Different. Yeah. A whole abundance of different things to grow. You will have those on your plate every morning here.
Yeah, I watch you guys on Facebook and Instagram and everything, and always looking at these very fresh dishes, you know, and it just, everything looks just so like fresh, I mean, and vibrant. You want to eat.
Fresh, you know? And clean, it's organic. Some of the stuff is just picked just even minutes before you're consuming them. But we do, you know, we've grown with how we view food, and we view food as medicine now. And, mm-hmm. and you know, you are a result of what you put into your body. And so when people stay here, we only want them to put really good, nutritious food in them. So
especially if you're hiking too, and you know, running around and doing all kinds of things, that you do actually need some sustenance in there.
Yeah,
you know?
And it's the difference between getting up from a meal and feeling real good after you've had a meal mm-hmm. versus feeling bloated and having too much. But it's a big goal of ours, and something that we spent, this past year that or half year that we took off in the wintertime, we went on a culinary crusade, and we just upped our game that much more mm-hmm. Due to Ooh. What we could find in South America, Latin America, and different countries.
Nice.
Yeah.
We're actually putting out a blog on that sometime this week.
Awesome.
One of the things that we like to say about breakfast is better fuel gives you a better day. So we look at food as not only an experience, because we put a lot of love mm-hmm. into what we cook, but also great fuel for your body.
Mm-hmm.
Really important, you know. And then we have a wonderful farmers market in Abiquiu also. So from about the end of May through October, all the local farmers show up in the village on Tuesdays with everything from honey and flowers and eggs to vegetables, some meat. So it's just a beautiful farmers market. So if we can't grow something here, that's our next stop, is to support all the local farmers. You know, there's farmers all up and down the Rio Shama in northern New Mexico. And so we definitely want to support their efforts.
I love that. Awesome. And as travelers, we go to farmers markets too, because we want to taste what is, you know, from the land and from the people, and meet the
and
people behind
colorful.
It. Yeah.
It's so colorful. You know, mm-hmm. it's like, it's just colorful and exciting and smells good and it's fun.
And they normally have music and all kinds of other things.
Music,
to
local at. Musicians, and it's fun. It really is. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So you said you have a guest kitchen. So for those staying overnight, if they wanted to cook something from the farmers market, they're able to do that?
They are. And it was our original intention that they would do that often. But Carolyn and I do most of the cooking when people stay here. So it is available for guests to use. But we furnish most of the food while they're here. We cook 7 or 8 things very, very well. And the guests get a pick of those items that we offer here. And so especially the returning guests rarely ever bring their own food. They almost always eat their meals here.
But it is a full kitchen. So it's got an oven, a stove, a microwave, you know, all the pots, pans, seasonings, everything you would need. And then there's also an infrared propane grill outside so people can grill too. So some people will show up with steaks that they can keep in the refrigerator and, you know, do great meals. So
I love that, you know, you actually have that kind of different experience for people, especially when you're out in the boonies. You're not in the boonies, but you are in the New Mexico boonies. So the dogs are going off. Sorry, I don't know. People may hear some dogs getting excited about grilling, but yeah, that people are able to do that, I think, is exciting. So as a farmer's market, you said, goes for a while. Is there art that people can experience beyond Georgia O'Keeffe?
There is. So, you know, if you stay with us, we'll help connect you to any of the artists out here. We have a pretty lengthy list of artists who, with advanced reservations, will do studio tours. So, you know, Georgia kind of started the art colony here, and now we have so many wonderful artists who do all types of different art, from metal to jewelry, painting, clay. It's just really amazing. So there's a lot of artists that have studios and galleries on their properties. And then there's those studio tours we talked about, which are set times where everybody is open.
Yeah.
You have to make an appointment. You can just go and show up. So we definitely want people to see the work of these artists. And then there's you know, galleries that are open. There's a new one called the Abiquiu Dome that's open. There's Nest, which is open. So there's a few galleries that are open throughout the high season, you know, the summer season as well. They're usually closed in the off season.
It's neat to me that you can get the art and then going, you've got the studio tours, but being able to actually go and make appointments to go in the studio and meet the artists. Okay. So Abiquiu, the village itself, so it has galleries in there. We've just never been to Abiquiu, so we don't know what to expect going into the actual. Is there shops and restaurants in Abiquiu itself, or is it?
So that's a great question. And in Abiquiu itself, in the little village, which is up on a mesa top, you've got Georgia's home and studio. You have one or two little shops, and then you have a large shop called Bosshard's Gallery, which is so wonderful. It's like a museum. It's like he travels the world and just buys unique things and he brings it back to Abiquiu to sell them. So wonderful, wonderful items in that gallery. And there's the church up there. It's a, you know, got a long history, that church. And then there's the library. Aww. And that's just up on the top. And then down along the main road, we have the Abiquiu Cafe. We have Bodie's General Store, which is a really traditional general store, which is very cool.
Oh, I love old school general stores. You can get a shirt and tractor parts in the same place.
Exactly. And a fishing pole. So,
you know, there you go.
Bodie's.
They're fun to browse through. They really are.
Yeah.
There's a handful of great restaurants now. Cafe Sierra Negra, Frosty Cow, Fire and Ice, you know, Bodie's has a little market in there, Abiquiu Cafe. So Mama Cita's Pizza.
We want that.
Yeah. It's like traditional New York style pizza. And then there's a little bar, which is our favorite. So,
but it's hard to find most of the galleries though, because most of the galleries are attached or near people's homes. And so by appointment is how, and I over half of our guests make some sort of contact or touch with the gallery while they're here. And Carolyn does a great job of arranging that. So,
So you guys help out with the guests coming in. That's our experience of staying at so many B&Bs. Like the B&B, you know, the innkeepers know where to go. Like, here's the hiking you want to do. Oh, you only want to do a short trail and maybe not so much sunlight. Well, this one's good for you. Oh, you know, we know this person down the street if you're looking for that. But it seems like your location is so central that people could stay for, you know, a week and go do hiking, the outdoors, and then, you know, obviously sure. the village, the Abiquiu itself, but go do some day trips out to Santa Fe and Taos. And, right. you know, from there. So that's kind of cool.
Yeah, they do that. Take the Toltec and Cumbres Railroad.
Cool.
It's just right up the road in Chama. Spend a day up fly fishing in Chama. There's a lot of those connections that they can make. And it's, and I'm going to toot Carolyn's horn here a little bit because she won't do this, but she is the smartest concierge there is up in the area. She is the go-to person for all those varied interests that you were talking about. Carolyn can take you there.
Awesome. So she's going to hook you up and you're going to hook everybody up with food. That's what's going on. Tom's a foodie, and that's
awesome.
So what about people flying in? Where's the best place to fly in to get to you and rent a car? Because obviously they're going to probably want to rent a car, right?
They'll want to. I mean, we can hook them up with a driver if they don't want to, but Albuquerque Airport is a large international airport, and that's about 2.5 hours away.
That's not so bad.
Two local airports, Santa Fe and Taos, and the Taos airport is actually expanding and growing. Those are small regional airports. You can also rent cars at Santa Fe. I'm not sure about Taos. So those are the three choices, but you know, generally you can get more flights and cheaper flights in and out of Albuquerque.
That's not far too, and then you have a scenic drive up to you.
It's beautiful. Kind of cool. And you know, if people fly into Albuquerque and want to spend the night in Albuquerque, there's some great bed and breakfasts on the website for Albuquerque, and then they'll get up early in the morning and head out to Abiquiu, and that's generally how people do it. And then they'll go from Abiquiu to Santa Fe and then Santa Fe back to Albuquerque. So, you know, people kind of do the triangle when they get here.
Very cool. This sounds like so much fun. So do you book out? I know, like you said, people can book the house. Like, listen, the whole house. Like, I want the whole house. Champagne, breakfast, sounds good to me. Views. Mm. But, you know, you guys were on the cover of one of our magazines. You had a lady, Quality of Life, because it seems so quality of life. Lady painting out there. Do you get small groups coming, like small retreats, mini retreats coming out and staying with you? And if there's like more people that they go to, you know, the rentals, vacation rental kind of thing, does that happen?
It does. So we're lucky that kind of in a close enough proximity, there are a number of vacation rental homes. And of course, we're good friends with all of them. So, you know, we'll host retreats. We only do elopements or kind of micro weddings. We are not a big wedding venue, but we're perfect for yoga retreats. Like we had a yoga retreat last year. It was wonderful. And so people stayed here and then they rented 4 different houses in the area. And it's just a beautiful place. It's a beautiful place for that.
Yeah. Mm. I just feel all relaxed talking to you guys, both of us.
I know.
The dog's got all excited. I know Nancy's got the cat there. Yeah, you know,
I know the cat's here,
always some animal has to make its appearance, but they only do it when they feel like, ooh, something special's happening. It's like, let's do it. And you're not pet friendly, right? That's a good segue there. See,
it is a good segue. We have one suite that we do allow pets. So you can bring your pets. We limited it to one suite so that our guests that have allergies don't ever have to worry about pets being in their space. And we just don't allow them in the common areas, the plaza or the shared terrace. So, but you're sweet and there's 19 other acres to walk your pets on. So,
That's cool.
Yeah.
That's cool. Cause some travelers do.
Yeah. We recognize that the 4-legged family members are important. We had a
pet that
was important to us too. And so it's a member of the family and we want everybody to be able to travel the way they want to travel. And we know some people want to travel their pets.
Some pets are suited for it. Some pets aren't, you know, we end up taking care of the ones who aren't and they're cool too, but they're just like, hey, you're going somewhere. We're going to hang out with you. But this is excellent. I'm so glad you guys are ready for the season. I know it's already getting busy for you guys, right? So it's kind of like get on it if you're going to book, right? Get going.
We're launching a new website, and it's going to have a whole new, easier registration system. So within the next 30 days, you can just go and hit book now and book it. It'll be easy and fast, and it'll come to us, and we'll do all the work once we
get there. And everybody, it is so much better to go right directly, because if you have a change you want to make on your room, or if you want to add an extra guest to, you know, what's going on, another room, it's very hard to do it when you do those over with the OTAs, as we call them, but the, you know, all those other places that people have accounts with, it's better to go directly. And I know, because I've made those mistakes, and it's not fun.
And you know, another really important part of that is if you book through an OTA like Booking or Expedia or Airbnb or VRBO, I mean, they're all our partners, and you're welcome to book through those entities, but you're going to pay more. They're going to charge you a booking fee. So if you come to us directly, you're going to get our lowest price and no booking.
And someone who knows what's going on and can make any changes. Right. I know, because I've made the wrong decision and then had to walk flights of stairs with a full carload of luggage. And you know, we travel full time. So, you know, that's what happens. Yeah. So anyway, and they couldn't change the room. Sorry, you'll have to call booking.com and they'll change it for you. But we're booked. And so you're stuck. And I'm like, well, this sucks. All right, there's my lesson. And I've been talking about this for years on the show. And then I went and did it and went, you really are stupid. You didn't listen to yourself.
All right.
Yeah, I know. Well, it was snowing too. And I'm like, this is not fun. But anyway, you learn, you learn. But I always say, you know, what we can do is, you know, to support small business, I think is a very important thing that we do that as travelers. And there's nothing like actually connecting directly. So, but your website address will be the same, right? Everyone can still go to thegrandhacienda.com. Also for New Mexico Bed and Breakfast, we were talking about Albuquerque, Santa Fe, Taos, go to nmbba.org. And they have a brand new website too, which is really excellent. You can really see all these different bed and breakfast experiences across the country. So thank you so much for joining us.
Well, thank you for having us.
It was a real pleasure. And you got a cattail there, right there for you. So there it is. She apparently heard that you're pet friendly. So everyone, of course, keep up with us at bigblendradio.com. We are here every second Thursday talking about New Mexico, pet friendly and non-pet friendly. Thank you. Check out the bed and breakfast.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Gracious hosts, unique lodging, and tasty cuisine. New Mexico Bed and Breakfasts are New Mexico true. Our innkeepers are as special as New Mexico, and we're sharing their stories. Read about them and plan your trip at nmbba.org.